The amount of plastic in our environment is shocking. A big reason single-use plastic items like straws and water bottles. That's why the Canadian government is introducing new rules to phase out some of the single-use plastic. But what exactly is the issue here? This is Kayan Explains the single-use plastic problem. Let's start with Canada's new rules, which is a ban on some single-use plastic items. It targets six main groups: takeout bags, cutlery, takeout containers, those rings that hold cans, stir sticks, and straws. According to the government, Canadians use 15 billion plastic bags every year. That's a lot.
And that's important to talk about this single-use plastic, because this is probably one of the greatest problems that human beings are facing today. So Canada has taken a good step to try to ban, phase out all this single-use plastic.
But before we get into it, let's make sure we even know what a single-use plastic is. Well, I know what plastic is, right? But do I really know what plastic is? When we think of plastic, we mostly think of synthetic plastic. Synthetic plastic is made from fossil fuels like crude oil. In 1907, the first fully synthetic plastic was created. But it didn't take off before the 1950s, when it became popular for all kinds of consumer goods. Since then, over 9 billion metric tons of plastics have been produced. And half of that was only in the last two decades alone. A study from 2017 found that the plastic industry's largest market is packaging. One of the biggest reasons, a shift from reusable to single-use containers. Water bottles, which aren't included in Canada's ban, by the way. Plastic bags and other single-use plastics are made for convenience, but they're also made to be thrown out. Single-use literally means use it once. And if you think recycling them is the solution, well, think again, because only 8% of plastic is actually being recycled. The big problem with single-use plastic, the plastic doesn't biodegrade. Instead, it breaks down into tiny little pieces called microplastics. It sounds cute, right? But scientists have found microplastic inside of humans, including in our lungs and blood.
Microplastics are everywhere, and they might be in our foods, they are in the water, they are even in the air, right?
Am I breathing in plastic right now? It's not only us humans are affected, but also all furry, scaly, and feathered friends. In our ocean, microplastics are being eaten by tiny creatures, which are eaten by bigger creatures like fish and continue up the food chain. And large pieces of plastics are a problem too. Like, look at these beaches, plastic everywhere. Okay, so if you're like me, you're probably running to a list in your mind of all the single-use plastic you use. And maybe you're thinking, we have to stop using these things. But how? Bans, like the one in Canada, are supposed to help us phase out our need for these products over time. Other single-use items can help bridge the gap, like paper straws and bamboo cutlery. While our government tries to reduce plastic waste on a big scale, at home we could do it on a smaller scale. For example, gift giving and sale season is upon us. Juan José says that kids should think about how much plastic is in their wish list and where it all goes. This makes me think of mine. That's it for Kayan Explains. I'm Saba Vahedyousefi. Thank you for watching.